Εδώ είμαστε και πάλι για το δεύτερο ημίωρο. Έχουμε στην άλλη άκρη της γραμμής τον Σον Πράις. Hello, Σον.
Hello.
Hello.
How
are you? So, bad day for Manchester United today, huh?
we got a point. We were losing 2-1 until the last minute.
Yeah.
We saved the point. It's good.
It's good.
You know, after Liverpool lose to Chelsea tomorrow, then, you know.
Ah, are you sure? Okay. We'll see. So, one of the best London labels there. So, tell us about Fortuna Pop history so far.
Okay, well, I started a long time ago, in about 1996.
Mm-hmm.
And I started putting out, music by my friends, and then I just kept releasing records and I released the bands that I love and... try and do the best that I can for them.
Yeah. Son, tell us about the London music scene nowadays. Give us a picture.
I think it's really good at the moment, especially at the bottom level. There are lots of people promoting, doing things, especially for indie pop, which is, a lot of what I release. There's lots of people. There's Tweers Fuck Club and there's How Does It Feel Club, and there seems to be a bit of a revival of indie music in a way, but indie pop, not indie NME bands.
Yeah. And so, what about the internet? A new kind of market, maybe. Seems to me that the music industry still can find the right way, to handle things right with the internet. So far.
You mean the way to sell music? I think that. The best thing to do if you're a new band is to give away your music for free.
And right. You're so right.
I don't really think that that the internet is a bad thing. I know the big labels feel that they've lost money. I think it's a brilliant thing. The internet, it can get you to so many people. I can't understand how.
I agree. Yeah.
How anybody could have run a record label before the internet? I mean, I did, but people used to send me letters ordering the records, and now they send me emails. I can't remember how difficult it must have been before email and internet.
Yeah, you're right. Sean, tell us about Ladybug Transistor. Tell us some details. Yeah.
Okay, why do you ask about them?
The history of the band so far,
Okay, well, I've only been working with Ladybug for one album.
Mm-hmm.
Before that, they were on my friend's label on Track and Field. So I put an album out by them, I think, 2 years ago now. And they're just recording a new record in America.
Yeah.
So I think there'll be a new record next year, hopefully. They're coming over to Europe to play in Spain in December.
Mm-hmm. And what about the Pains of Being Pure at Heart?
The Pains of Being Pure at Heart, that's the craziest thing that's ever happened to my record label, I think.
Fantastic debut album, eh?
Yeah, everybody just seems to love them. I think they've just been in the right place at the right time. I think, maybe 2 years ago, 5 years ago, if you released a record, that the influences were indie pop and shoegaze, and the people would laugh at you. They look good, they sound great, and I just think that they're an amazing band, and I'm really happy that they've become so successful.
Mm-hmm.
It's just fantastic. They've sold so many more records on my label than anything else has ever done, so it's just been really interesting and really fun.
Yeah.
And they're lovely, lovely people. So I know you interviewed them in the summer.
Mm-hmm. Okay, Sean, thank you very much for your time for this interview. Okay, we'll be in contact anyway.
Thank you.
Okay, take care. Thank you again. Bye-bye.
Cheers. Bye-bye.